Good morning and welcome to Real Estate It Is That Simple on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. I am not your friendly host, Phil Nordella. Who is this crazy person? It is Taylor Williams Moniz. I am here because Phil is not feeling well. So, Patty, it's just you and I.
It's just us. But you are now the host. Not the hostess, but you are the true host.
The host.
Taylor Finley Williams Moniz, first of her name.
First of her name, absolutely.
Long may she reign.
Thank you. and of course, who is this? Patty, our favorite.
Hi!
How are you?
Doing good. How are you?
Yep. Should I bring up what happened on trivia a second ago or not?
Oh, no.
For anyone that's listening, it was very apparent to me how old I am compared to Patty based on some of the trivia questions he was asked on the last segment that he didn't know the answers to, that I just assumed everyone knew the answers to.
Okay, to be fair, I'm an outlier because I'm just, none of those are in my wheelhouse. Now, if you talked about like sports or.
So who is Paul Simon? He doesn't know who Paul Simon is.
No.
And he doesn't know the song American Pie.
I don't.
I'm not going to let you live this down.
I know the Jeffersons theme song.
Which is very strange. I don't know how you know these things. It makes
We're
no
sense. We're moving on up.
To the east side. I'm not going to sing. Anyway, so we, despite Phil not being here, we do have a full show, which I'm super excited about. And we are actually going to start with a guest, which is going to be great. We've got Miss Kim Kapelish on the phone. She is the owner and founder of Style My Space, which is a local home staging and design company. She's also the owner and founder of the Academy of Home Staging and Design, which has live and virtual business startup courses in home staging and interior design. She's been training students from everywhere from 2007 until now, and she's been on the show multiple times. We'd love to have her here. Kim, are you there?
I am. Good
Hi.
Morning. Good Thanks so much.
Thank you for being on the show. I'm so excited. So let's see how to start, which the normal question, how did you get into staging, home staging and design?
Well, I was initially a set designer. And prior to that, I was a real estate agent. So it just kind of seemed the natural direction to go into. My mom had heard from a relative of ours in San Francisco that she had staged her home, and she had talked to the stager and found out, you know, different information about schools. And so I researched it and looked into it and kind of just went in that direction. And then when I came to founding the school, after the classes that I took, I just was inspired maybe to do a better job, if I can say that.
Absolutely.
There was nothing hands-on.
Right.
There was nothing hands-on about the courses. And so when you're expected to help people with color palettes and the style and the design of their home, then one should think that you would probably learn those skill sets and space planning and different furniture styles and eras and architecture terms and things like that, as well as, you know, space planning. That's one of the real reasons why people would hire a home stager, especially to do certain rooms, because maybe the space planning is, people don't know what to do with those difficult areas. And so you need to do those things out in the field and have practice before you start and launch your own business telling other people how to what they should be doing to prep their home for sale.
Yeah, definitely. So I assume that's, like you were saying, that's what you teach in the school. So tell us about that. So if you're, you know, a new student that signs up, kind of walk me through kind of what the courses look like, what they learn moving forward.
Absolutely. So our courses are business startup. And so they're a little bit like boot camp. So we do home staging and we do interior design. People can attend live in New York or LA. As a matter of fact, we have an interior design course next week. And we do coaching and mentoring every step of the way. So we only take up to 10 students. And that was another thing that we found with a lot of the other schools. We'd have 25, 30 students. You wouldn't be able to ask any questions. You wouldn't get any feedback if there were any projects to do. And so we're completely different from that. So you learn all of the skill sets design-wise, and then you also learn all of the business that you need to know. We have how to start your business in 30 days and get it up and running. And then we also teach marketing and branding and all of the social media aspects so that you can attract clients for your new business.
That's amazing. So it's full service, basically.
It is, yes. It is the core training And it's like boot camp. You take it for a week, and then you are able to start your business. And we continue coaching after the course. So we always like to turn the coin. We're kind of your business partner without having to pay us after you complete the course.
Which is great. That's awesome.
Yeah.
So here's a question that I'm sure you get asked all the time. What's the difference between home staging and actual design?
So that is a very good question. So a lot of people aren't really sure about that difference, especially the consumer. But home staging would be someone that you would hire to prep your home when it's for sale, which is perfect for real estate. And so we would come in and advise and then possibly bring in additional inventory. For instance, my company in Santa Clarita is Style My Space, and we just do vacant homes, for instance.
Okay.
So we would bring in all of the inventory, head to toe, furniture, accessories, stage it like a model home, and then it's ready to go. Statistically, people can expect typically up to 10% higher offers than they might have gotten before. And of course, now that it's a seller's market, they're getting much higher. We had a client that had a $1 million house that got 200 over just a couple of months ago. So,
hey, that's good.
And then
that's great.
Yes, excellent. And they spent it was a pretty large property. They spent about $6,500 on the staging. And then interior design would be just suited just for you, specifically how you want your house. It's all about your needs, your function, your styles, your tastes, and the interior designer would help and help you renovate and help pick out materials, furniture, whatever it is that you need for your particular project.
Got it. Okay. And I'm actually going to talk about this later in the show about selling a house, but do you have any suggestions for, I know that you said that you do vacant houses, but any suggestions about if someone is going to sell their house, what can they do to prep it to make sure they can get, you know, top dollar?
Absolutely. So cleaning, obviously super essential. If your house needs paint, consider painting. Right now it's a seller's market, not as much of a need, but if your room is obviously needing painting, you can do that. Some people, especially agents in the Valley, have kind of taken on this trend where they're mini flipping the houses a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So there might be new flooring if need be, and obviously all the windows cleaned, freshen up the exterior, make it warm and inviting, maybe paint the front door, certainly power wash the house, or at least the front of the house
right.
and the windows, and definitely remove any drapery that is covering up any views. Light and bright cells. People always think their drapery that they bought 10 years ago is amazing because they spent a lot of money on it.
Right.
But the reality is if you have a good view or even any greenery, it doesn't even have to be a whole view of Santa Clarita, but, you know, even if you have some good greenery and a nice looking backyard, definitely just remove all of those.
Right.
It freshens up the house and again, light and bright. People are very attracted to that.
Light and bright. Okay. That's good. That makes sense. So going back to the classes that you talked about, because I know we have a lot of people that are in real estate, obviously, that hopefully listen to the show. So how would a real estate agent be able to use those classes to expand their offerings and hopefully attract new clients?
Sure. So especially if you're new or if you're already attracted to design,
right.
for instance, we have agents that come through. If you're a busy agent, not interested in any of this, I'm not suggesting it. But people who want to get involved, maybe working with investors, might take the interior design course because if you're advising the investor how to help flip the house of materials and things like that, that is very helpful for them. That takes a lot of work off of their plate. You might even project manage the flip. And so if you brought him the home and you're selling the home and you're staging the home, maybe in combination taking the staging course. For agents that just work primarily with sellers that already live in their home, not a lot of stagers do the occupied.
Right.
But if you had those skill sets yourself, that would be one and done, right? So if you're in a listing presentation and you know you're going up against a couple of other agents, it makes sense that you would maybe be able to say, I can help you prep this house for sale properly because I'm a certified home stager.
Right, which you have
the extra
knowledge.
And that might be the...
Yeah.
Right. And that might be the thing that pushes them over the edge and says, we really need to work with this agent.
Absolutely. When, and I think you said the next class is next week. How often do you offer them?
So the interior design class is just twice a year here in Los Angeles, sometimes three times a year. Next week is the last course of the year. It runs Monday the 8th all the way through Saturday afternoon. And if anyone wants to join that class, you can mention Phil's radio show, and we'll take $500 off as a gift from us. Yes. Perfect. And then the other classes are coming in winter and spring. We'll have new classes live and virtual. And we even have a Spanish bilingual course, virtual course coming out. And so those will all be available next year.
That's awesome. So if our listeners are interested in doing that, how would they contact you?
Sure. Our website is theacademyofhomestaging.com. And they can certainly call in and talk to one of our advisors. The phone number is 800-574-5576. And I'll repeat that again if anybody didn't have time to grab a pencil. The website is theacademyofhomestaging.com. And the phone number is 800-574-5576.
Awesome. I think this is just so interesting. My mom was in interior design, and I love staging and HGTV and all things interested in this. So I think this course, like you said, the boot camp, I think is so beneficial. So hopefully everybody listening, if they're interested, will call. Anything else that you want to tell us about the class or what you have going on?
Well, I mentioned the new classes. The class is, I have to tell you, most people, Taylor, that take the class, by the end of it, they're almost in tears. They don't want to leave. They've all kind of become a little family.
Aww.
Yes, and they're all learning together. So our coaching and mentoring, it's not just us. It's also the other students that are pitching in and, noticing. It's the learning there. So, like, when you go to attend a college course and you get your paper back and there's a grade on it, there's really not much in terms of feedback.
Right.
And some of our courses, like the interior design course next week, they're actually going into a live property. They're going to interview the homeowner and find out what she wants to renovate and what she likes and doesn't like. And everybody's going to come up with their own plan of what that could look like and present that in a board form.
Right.
For anybody who doesn't know that, it's just all of the images would be collected together and then you're doing a presentation to the homeowner. And that homeowner is going to select the person that she likes the design best and actually work with them after the project. And so it's not just the instructor giving feedback, but somebody else in the class might say, well, I love how you pulled all of that together, and I can see how that all works, even though I wouldn't have thought that it would have worked beforehand. Like maybe the rug pulls everything together or something like that.
Right.
So you learn not only from the other people, but you learn from looking at their design and seeing how their thought process went along the way.
Which is collaborative.
So we also do an exercise.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, that's great.
And we also do
Go ahead.
An exercise in our warehouse. So they get to see how our warehouse is set up and how we store things. But in addition, they work as a team, and they draw cards, basically. And so they get a client, and then they get a style. And then they go through our warehouse, and they pick out everything to pull that style together. And we have an empty room, and they put all of that together in the room to see how it works. And they work as a team to pull that look together.
That's amazing. So it's
a lot of
real-time learning, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Which is great. Awesome. Well, thank you so, so much again, Kim Kapelish. I really appreciate you being on the show, as always. And I know Phil wishes that he were here, and he says thank you. And give us just one more time the website and the phone number so that people can make sure that they do have the pencil to write it down one more time.
Sure. Okay, great. It's theacademyofhomestaging.com, and the phone number is 800-574-5576. Anyone listening needs home staging, feel free to give us a call. My direct cell is 818-438-1211.
Awesome. Well, thank you so, so, so much. We appreciate you. Have an awesome.
And thank you.
Of course. Have an awesome Friday.
You too.
Home staging is something that's so interesting to me. Oh yeah, totally. I know it sounds silly, but I watch so much HGTV and like what a house what a house looks like, and then when you have a stager come in and they change everything and like how much the value increases, I wish I had an eye for that, which I don't, which Kim does.
No, that's true. She totally does.
Yeah, she's wonderful.
Yeah.
So next segment, we have so much to talk about. So I don't know if you've been reading real estate news at all, but Zillow is basically imploding.
I have heard, actually.
Yeah, which is very interesting. And of course, Sweet Phil is not here because
I know,
which is sad because you know how much he loves Zillow.
Right.
But I'm thinking we should take a quick break because we have a lot to talk about, and we'll come back with Zillow. Stay tuned. You're on your tippy toes, creeping around like no one knows. Think you're so criminal. Bruises on both my knees for you. Don't say thank you. Oh, please, I do what I want when I'm wanting to. My soul, so cynical. So you're a tough guy, like you're really rough guy. Just can't get enough guy, just always so puff guy. I'm that bad type, make your mama sad type, make your girlfriend mad type. If you're thinking of selling your home, have Phil Nordella come out and give you a free, no obligation, property valuation. Just call 661-312-3561. It's that simple. Marla Ferris at Augusta Financial is the consummate mortgage professional, committed to helping you turn your dream of homeownership into reality. With more than 22 years in the finance mortgage industry, Marla brings extensive experience and top knowledge to help make your loan experience hassle-free. Given her honesty, integrity, and attention to detail, she is the loan officer you can trust. Marla knows what it takes to get you the best loan, the best rate, and the best service in the industry. You'll find Marla Ferris at MarlaFerris.com.
Take the stress out of moving. Affordable Quality Moving and Storage has been owned and operated in Santa Clarita since 1996. They excel at relieving you of the pressures of moving. You can be assured your belongings are safe and will arrive at your new location, whether it's down the street or across the country. Discover the difference. AQMS, Affordable Quality Moving and Storage. Read the reviews online at aqmsnationalmoving.com. AQMS, Santa Clarita's favorite moving company.
If you're looking for an SCV-based home design firm you can trust, look no further. Style My Space is a recognized leader in luxury vacant home staging and interior design projects for all of Northern Los Angeles County since 2006. Their five-star reputation for beautiful staging installations helps sellers realize up to 10% higher offers in as little as one-third the time as non-staged homes. Get an instant quote on our website at stylemyspace.com. That's stylemyspace.com.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nordella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnordella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nordella, eXp Realty, it's that simple.
Your hometown station.
KHTS is the only station I listen to.
98.1 FM and AM 1220.
Welcome back to Real Estate It's That Simple on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. I don't think I waved earlier. I apologize to anybody who's watching.
You can never forget the wave.
The wave, right? The wave, the wave. How sweet was Kim?
She was sweet. I know. Yeah.
That makes me happy.
Yeah.
Good stuff. So we got a lot. We got a lot with Zillow, so I think we need to do some in the news. I sound like it, right?
And now, in the news.
But wait, I think just because you are the one and the only today,
Hey guys and dolls, it's your favorite time of the show, Taylor Talk.
It's really a 1 hour show of Taylor Talk, really.
Oh, it is. We should have done that at the beginning. So I think I feel kind of bad because Zillow is just imploding and all of this, I'm reading all of these articles and Phil and I talked a couple of days ago about all this. So I have all this content, but he's not here to talk about it.
Yes,
but,
indeed.
But, all right, I think we should start with Zillow is about to shut down their iBuying program. right? Mm-hmm. You know what iBuyers are.
I do. They're internet.
You see all the crazy commercials with, we'll buy your house, but you don't have to pay anything, and there's no commission, and there's no blah, 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 right? That's mm-hmm. That's what the iBuyers are. So Zillow is completely shutting down their iBuyer program. Mm-hmm. Did you hear about that?
Yeah. And also, Taylor, I think we have a caller right now. Oh, we do have a caller.
Is it my husband?
I don't know. Sir, you can go. You can go now, sir.
I am her husband.
Oh!
I'm her studio husband.
Look at you husband. Calling in.
You know, I don't recognize the voice.
Well, hi, actually, Phil. I went to a college class. It was titled, How to Sound Sexy on the Radio. How's it working? Is it working okay?
You're doing a good job. I'm glad you called in, because I have, like I said, all of this content. But how are you feeling, by the way?
You know what? I'm okay. It's one of those things to where every so often I'll get a cold, but usually I'll take echinacea and golden seal, and it'll nip it in the bud.
Right.
But because I haven't cold in at least a couple of years, I tried to take those things, but they were all expired. And so I couldn't take it, so it hit me. It hit me pretty hard. I played poker till like midnight, and then woke up the next day going, oh, I don't feel that's great. So anyway.
Should we talk about the poker until midnight? I feel like maybe that's a separate issue.
Should we also talk about how tea is expired?
Yeah. Echinacea and stuff. It expires.
Really? I thought tea has like a really long shelf life.
You know what? A lot of stuff has expired over the last couple of years since COVID hit. But I went over. Here's what's weird. I went over to Ralph's and said, I'd like to get some echinacea. They went, we don't carry it. And I'm like, you don't carry it? Oh, my God. It's so great for colds.
Oh, for sure.
Said, I don't care. Yeah, they didn't care.
Wow.
Yeah, so.
Well, for what it's worth, you sound great. And I think it's comical that, you know, I can't mention Zillow without you calling it. I was actually wondering. I'm like, maybe Phil will call. We'll see.
I'm sitting here on the couch. I was listening to the show. I'm loving Kim Capellis. That was awesome.
Oh, she's great.
You know, anybody's looking for a new career. You know what? Go to that. That's incredible. And for her to give $500 off for mentioning the show, that's amazing.
Yeah, definitely.
I love that.
And I love that it's boot camp too. It's like you can get in, you can learn, and then you can be marketable, and they help you with that, which I think is so great.
And you know, the whole thing that she said about agents that actually work with investors, that's a great idea.
Absolutely.
You know? Mm-hmm.
Yep. It's an extra skill to have. So you're chomping at the bit. So where would you like to start with the delightful Zillow situation?
You've
got
to kind of start from the beginning.
Okay.
Because it's one of those things to where Zillow, everybody knows Zillow, right?
Correct.
You want to actually find something, you have an address, you get on Zillow, that's great. One of my clients just actually emailed me at 5:30 this morning saying, hey, check this thing out on Zillow. I want to know if you can show it to me today. And I'm like, well, yeah, okay. Excuse me.
Okay.
So as I slowly start to lose my voice. Okay, so Zillow's been around for a long time. They're killing it by taking the information from the MLSs,
right?
And then putting it on their feed. And then they get calls from the public, and then they sell those leads back to the realtors, which is messed up.
Right, which
but
we've talked
what
about.
It is. It's a business model.
Yeah, many times. But that's what they do. So, yep.
Yep. So they go from there to the point where they say, okay, this is all we're going to do. We're never going to get into the real estate business. Liars. But what can you do? Right?
Liars.
So then they continue to go deeper and deeper and deeper to compete with the actual agents. Now, lately, they've competed a couple of times by saying, we'll never have agents that work for us.
Right.
Liars. Okay.
Right.
They do
Again.
Have agents that work for them.
Yes.
We're never going to get into iBuying, you know, where we're going to buy homes to compete with the realtors. Liars. Right. I'm sorry. I mean, I know it makes
this
me sound
is why
terrible,
he called but... in. I knew it would be too tempting for him not to call in because he loves Zillow. No. Yes. Liars. No.
Anyway, Open Door came out. They were the first ones. That's all they do. They basically just buy and flip houses.
Correct.
Then OfferPad came out. Then Zillow says, we want to get in the game. We've got way too much money, so we're going to start that. Their stock goes through the roof. It's at $200-some-odd a share. Everything's terrific. Then Redfin gets in the business. They're saying, oh, my God, we're killing it. But then last week or at the beginning of this week, Zillow comes out and says, hey, you know, we kind of have a problem.
Yeah.
We're going to actually stop buying for 3 months till the end of the year. Mm-hmm. Everyone went, what? Yeah, we got too much inventory.
That was their initial statement, correct?
That was their initial statement.
Which
right?
gave everybody pause because it's like, okay, you have too much inventory.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, what
right.
the heck does that mean? Yeah.
So I thought, well, okay, you know, I get it. They got too much inventory. they want to actually see if they can't, you know, fluff these and sell them. But within a week, they came back and said, guess what? It just doesn't work. This model just doesn't work for us.
Nope.
And so we're not going to do anything. Well, they also said that they're going to have to fire 25% of their workforce, mm-hmm. right? They also had their stocks. Okay, so the beginning of the year, their stocks were at 200. Now I think today they're at 60.
60? Yeah, so on Tuesday, that's when, and reading from Inman, they made the startling announcement that they plan to shut down the iBuying operation altogether. The move should take several quarters and will also result in Zillow reducing its workforce by approximately 25%.
25%.
Yeah, which is huge. So the company founder, Rich Barton, said that we've determined that the unpredictability in forecasting home prices far exceeds what we anticipated, and continuing to scale Zillow offers would result in too much earning and balance sheet volatility, which I thought was interesting.
Okay, so hang on one second.
I'm hanging.
All right?
I'm hanging.
I don't want you to bury the lead there.
Okay.
There was something that they put in there that I found fascinating.
Uh-huh.
It was to wind down Zillow offers. They said that they can't basically predict what things are worth.
Correct. Which then gets
gets
into the Zestimate, right? I know that's where you're going.
Wait a minute. Stop the clock.
I know.
Their Zestimates have been out there since day one, and they've been saying we're the best at predicting what things are worth.
Right.
So what does that do? That invalidates everything, because they were using the Zestimates when it came to actually buying these homes. And it says right here,
right.
Zillow has been unable to accurately price homes for future sales. But that's what their whole, you know, platform is.
Absolutely. I mean, you and I were talking about this the other day. I mean, typically when I have a potential client that calls and it's a real estate issue, I Google the address, right? And then obviously the first thing that shows up is Zillow, and I look at the Zestimate, and usually it's too high, at least in my experience, but it's there, and that's what it's used for. It's not used for the photos of the property necessarily. It's, hey, who owns this, and how much do we think it's worth? So for them to say that it's too volatile and unpredictable and they can't forecast home values, that that's huge.
And I gotta tell you something. Agents have been saying this all along.
Yes.
You go out on a listing presentation and you do the comps for that neighborhood, and the house is worth, let's just say, $700,000.
Yep.
Excuse me.
You're good.
I feel really bad that I can barely talk. You guys can understand me though, right?
Oh yeah, you sound fine.
Okay, good. Perfect. Okay. So we go out there, we do the comps for the neighborhood. We see the condition of the house because we're inside it. We put all the value in to where it is. And we say it's worth $700,000.
Right.
And they go, Zillow says it's worth $780,000. And it's like Zillow doesn't know what they're talking
about.
Which
is so frustrating.
This just solidifies it.
Oh, okay. 100%.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're kind of happy about that. So
I think
it says,
so.
Tuesday's earnings report also showed that iBuying has been extremely costly for Zillow. Duh. While the company pulled in $1.7 billion in revenue during the third quarter of 2021, it also lost $328 million in that time. So,
and it says virtually all of those losses were from iBuying.
Yep. So, exactly.
Yep. So those things that you see on TV, we'll buy it for nothing. Don't do it. Don't listen to it.
They are a behemoth still, in all fairness.
They
were making a ton of money. They will go back to making a ton of money, and it might not be a bad stock to buy, actually, because now that they're down to $63 a share or whatever it is today. It might not be a bad stock to buy because they will bounce back and go back to, let's just clean off this Zillow offers thing that made us no money and go back to being a behemoth again.
Yeah, I think.
However, they were saying in one of these articles that they said, look, you know what? We're going to make a bunch of money on showing time. Well, you and I know that showing time has not been well received for the fact that Zillow bought it.
Right.
Okay.
Right. Cause people that have a bad taste in their mouth, like you do.
Exactly right.
Mm-hmm.
So just to tell everybody exactly what showing time is,
yes,
on the MLS, if you want to actually not have the agent call you to set up a time to show your listing, okay, and that you can actually get on showing time, you have to give all your clients information, and then they will set it up for you so that you know when people are going to go buy your listing. The problem with that is, Zillow bought that technology.
Right.
And that means that you're giving Zillow all the information on your clients.
Right.
Well, they're saying we're not going to do anything about it. But are they? They've lied before in the past. Mm-hmm. So why wouldn't they be able to say, okay, we're going to take that information and we're going to actually put it out there to where we're going to start contacting your people. If we find that they haven't bought anything in 6 months, maybe we'll contact them. Well, that hasn't been well received.
Absolutely.
I've never used showing time and I won't use showing time, but there's a lot of companies out there that are shooting for them.
Mm-hmm.
And so if they're saying, you know, we're going to still make a bunch of money on showing time, that's not necessarily true.
Right.
Because there's a lot of companies out there that are actually saying, hey,
then aren't gonna
you know
use
what?
It.
We're coming. We're coming. And we don't own a real estate company.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
So you can give us your information. You got no problem with that. I would be interested in that. That's a good thing.
Did you read in all of these articles about Zillow that there was a lot of talk about housing bubble, housing bubble, housing bubble? Like, this is kind of the start of, I don't know, a collapse or anything like that. Do you have any thoughts there? Because that makes me nervous.
No. Collapse, no. Correction, yes. There has to be a correction,
okay.
Right? It is cyclical. It goes up, it has to come down.
Mm-hmm.
It goes back down, it has to come back up. So we're actually walking into kind of a perfect storm.
Oh.
When I say that, the buyer pool, again, hasn't seemed to dry up yet, but it's slowed down, okay? Interest rates, because of inflation, are starting to tick up.
Right.
And but it's interesting. It doesn't seem like the amount of houses that are out there, the inventory, it doesn't seem like it's gone through the roof like I thought it would. But we are kind of going into a correction, so which is going to be interesting to see what happens.
Did you and I bet on that? You know, we normally bet. Did I win?
I forgot about that.
No, you probably
won. But it's not. The bet's not over until the end of December, right?
I know, which it's already November. So what? Yeah. What other buzz? I mean, among you and other agents with the Zillow, is this just something that we're talking about because we're not huge fans of Zillow, or is this making massive waves?
Oh, no, no, this is huge.
Yeah.
This is huge in the real estate industry. Okay, so now here's a couple things, and this is one of the things I wanted to ask you about.
Uh-oh, okay.
Okay, so Open Door, the co-founder of Open Door, slams Zillow, calls their portals.
I saw that.
They call their portals tech horrible. And it's like, wow. So this guy, Keith Rebois, okay, I don't know if he's French or not, but Keith
Rebois. That's how
Rebois,
I would pronounce it, too, yep.
Yeah. Also said on Twitter Wednesday that he expects Zillow to suffer even greater losses than they admit to.
Right.
Wow. Okay, that's a punch in the face, right? So here's this guy, and he's going, because Open Door right now is number one.
Right.
Zillow obviously was a thorn in their side. So now they're saying basically, you know, the cocky talk from this guy is basically saying, hey, you know what? I told you a long time ago that their portal and their tech sucked.
Mm-hmm.
And it just he's got down here, if you read the SPAC filings, we explained how our algorithms actually worked versus Zillow's, which are horrible. And so they even said, you know, how it just seems wrong that two public companies, one can actually say, guess what, we're going to go through the roof now because of this.
Right.
And they were terrible.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, there's just something that seems to be wrong, and people are actually going, as a public company, is it okay to make this type of statement? I mean, they went, in my conviction that Zillow will have even greater losses than they admit to, and hence they decline more, is not subject to insider trading's duties. So I'm not sure exactly what's happening with this, but it sounds like the guy that owns Open Door is trying to get more people to buy their stock. And here's what's an interesting thing about Open Door.
Yep.
Gotta get so excited. Okay. Open Door.
I knew you'd call in because you love this.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't mean to hijack you.
No, you're good.
So Open Door, they're not out of the woods. They've been getting crushed, right? Their stock started at 40. I think now it's 20.
I think, yeah.
Right? So
yeah, below 20.
But they've even admitted right now, because they're a brand new public company, they've even admitted right now that they have to show their shareholders business that they're doing. So to do that, they're giving more than what the houses should go for as an iBuyer platform, and they're getting crushed when it comes to showing a profit.
Right.
Because they're not.
Mm-mm.
Okay? They're losing money just as, let me see, it says in February their stock was at 39. Now it's at 21. Yeah, how are they doing? They're not doing so
not
great.
Doing
they're
well
down 50%.
Either. Right.
So anyway, it's one of those things to where everybody keeps saying, you know what, if we're smart, we'll probably short all Open Door and Zillow stocks. Because they just keep going down.
So here, when reading these articles, the legal part of it that I looked at, so the co-founder said that Zillow is not able to predict future value, right? But not the present value. So I'm wondering if there's some sort of, I assume there's some sort of loophole, right? Because they're locked in what's, you know, on the internet is content, which is there, which they can't change, right? But future value is something different. So I think that they're trying to do a little CYA, if you know what that means, right?
Yep.
Moving forward, which,
And they understand now that it worked for the last couple of years because everything's gone up so much to where people give them their properties and give them basically their equity.
Right.
And then they turn around and in 6 months later, all of a sudden the place is worth $50,000 more because that's what the type of values that are going up right now,
right?
Which is ridiculous. Now, they realize, they see the writing on the wall, that that's not going to keep happening.
Exactly.
So if they keep giving the type of prices that they're giving, it's going to get ugly.
Yeah.
And they're bleeding more than they are. So for them to actually pull out, I think it's actually pretty smart.
I think so, too.
Right? They're going to go back
and
dance with the woman who brought them, right? They're going to actually...
Which is what you should do as a gentleman, right? Yeah.
Exactly right. Exactly right. They should forget about the other one that just walked in the door and just go, look, we made money on selling leads to realtors and lying to them. We've made a lot of money doing that. So let's just cut our losses, which makes sense.
Let's go back. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So, hey, Phil, we have to...
where it goes.
It is, definitely. We need to take a quick break. Are you able to stay with us or do you gotta go?
I will do my very best.
Okay, perfect. We're going to sell sell some TVs, refrigerators, something, but we'll be back. Stay with us.
White shirt, now red, my bloody nose sleeping.
If you're thinking of selling your home, have Phil Nordella come out and give you a free, no obligation, property valuation. Just call 661-312-3561. It's that simple.
If you're looking for an SCV-based home design firm you can trust, look no further. Style My Space is a recognized leader in luxury vacant home staging and interior design projects for all of Northern Los Angeles County since 2006. Their five-star reputation for beautiful staging installations helps sellers realize up to 10% higher offers in as little as one-third the time as non-staged homes. Get an instant quote on our website at stylemyspace.com. That's stylemyspace.com.
Marla Ferris at Augusta Financial is the consummate mortgage professional, committed to helping you turn your dream of homeownership into reality. With more than 22 years in the finance mortgage industry, Marla brings extensive experience and top knowledge to help make your loan experience hassle-free. Given her honesty, integrity, and attention to detail, she is the loan officer you can trust. Marla knows what it takes to get you the best loan, the best rate, and the best service in the industry. You'll find Marla Ferris at MarlaFerris.com.
Take the stress out of moving. Affordable Quality Moving and Storage has been owned and operated in Santa Clarita since 1996. They excel at relieving you of the pressures of moving. You can be assured your belongings are safe and will arrive at your new location, whether it's down the street or across the country. Discover the difference. AQMS, Affordable Quality Moving and Storage. Read the reviews online at aqmsnationalmoving.com. AQMS, Santa Clarita's favorite moving company.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nordella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnordella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nordella, eXp Realty, it's that simple.
Your,
I love it.
Right on.
Your hometown station.
Good morning and welcome back to Real Estate It's That Simple on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. And I keep forgetting to introduce myself. Taylor Williams-Moniz here with our fabulous producer, Patty, and Phil on the phone, who sounds much better than you think you sound, I promise. No, you sound delightful.
Yeah, you know, everybody knows you. You don't have to introduce yourself. Taylor Williams-Moniz, you're famous.
Oh, no, I'm not really, but I'm just
and
thinking,
the first of a name.
The first of a name. No, but when you do the intro, you always say, you know, Phil Nordella. I'm like, oh, man, I need to say my name. So that's who I am. Okay, so I have – thank you for joining us for this third segment. This is a fun surprise. This morning I was all stressed out that I was going to be alone, and now you're here. So.
You're never alone when I'm here.
Very true, very true.
I can hold somewhat of a conversation.
I had to crash the party. When you said Zillow, all of a sudden I went, what?
I know,
what?
I know.
My ears perked up. I went, oh, no.
5 seconds later, he's on the line.
On the line, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. I found an interesting article. It's 15 Real Estate Pros share their market prediction trends for 2022 and beyond. And you are a real estate pro. So I kind of want to go through some of these and see what your reaction is and see if you agree or not.
Fun. I'm ready.
Right. Okay. So although real estate is seen as one of the most stable and profitable markets in the U.S., it is not immune to major cyclical changes, right? So this is from Forbes, and their business council members are sharing their predictions for market trends in 2022. So the first one is trading shares. Trading shares of individual real estate assets is about to go mainstream. We are currently in the e-trade phase of investing in commercial real estate. In the next year, I think we will transition to the Robinhood phase as real estate investing becomes more accessible. So real estate investing, what do you think about that?
That would scare me. And it's just for the fact that that's commercial,
right?
And so what have people learned over the last couple of years? That they don't necessarily need to go to an office. So people are buying homes that are geared around home work. And therefore, it would scare me a little bit to start investing in buildings that you may see over the long run have less and less occupancy. So that's just my opinion.
Totally agree. I think the same. I mean, as somebody that's working from home part-time now, I definitely agree with you. Okay.
Yep.
All right. This next one, I mean, this makes me happy, which it shouldn't, but it'll make sense. Increasing complexity of local zoning and permitting. The complexity of local zoning and permitting process, i.e. municipalities and townships, will become increasingly more valuable to understand. Planning and zoning offices have a major influence in master planning that governs where real estate can be developed, how it can be entitled, and for which it intended uses or purposes. Engage directly with local planning departments or your friendly lady lawyer at Donahoe Young and Williams.
There you go.
So what do you think about that one? I think this is true.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. You know, because your average person would want to actually do something and buy a piece of property and maybe see if they can't it sounds good on, saying, I'd like to build a house. But they have no idea when it comes to getting through all the red tape of all of those things.
Exactly.
And so I think it's invaluable to have somebody like you to be able to say, just bring it to us. We'll actually deliver it to you when it comes to all the things that you need to get past.
Exactly.
And it just keeps getting worse, which makes it better for you.
I know. That's why I said it's selfishly, I get that one. But yeah, it is. It's, like you said, there's a lot of red tape. And then, think about zoning and Belarus and things like that, right? And what you can't bring. And air rights. We could talk about that on a whole nother show. So,
There's a lot. I almost actually bought this last week. I came very close. My son sent me a Zillow, believe it or not, thing.
Ha ha.
From a place across the street from a place that he's building on a lake. He goes, Dad, buy this house. And I went, well, okay. He goes, it's literally across the street from our house that
you're
we're going to be living in.
You buy it.
And I went, no. I said, well, okay, I'll buy it maybe as an investment. $625,000. I'm looking at it. It's only 1,350 square feet.
Oh, gosh. It's tiny.
But it's on an acre.
Okay.
Right?
Oh, so it's got land.
It's on an acre, which is kind of cool. It's in good shape and everything. And I'm like, okay, I'll do the math. I'll put 20% down. I'll have to put $30,000 into putting some furniture in it, and I'll Airbnb it.
Right? Oh.
And so I'll be into it for about $170,000. I'll Airbnb it. And my payment on it will be about $27,000 a year. And I'll probably get somewhere between $35,000 and $40,000 a year Airbnb. So I talked to the realtor. I said, this is my idea. I figure I can give you $650. I'll give you $25,000 over asking. She goes, well, that would be our best offer. And I said, great. I said, now here's my idea, though, and I don't know Idaho. I want to Airbnb it. She goes, you can't. And I went,
dun,
really?
Dun, dun.
Yeah. She said, you can't, which is interesting because Chris, who's on the lake, can. But
that
now,
is bizarre.
If you cross the street, it's a different CC&Rs.
Right.
So if I wouldn't have checked into that and actually bought it, I'd be sitting on $27,000 because I wouldn't live in it. So I'd have to rent it out, you know, full
Cameron
entire
and,
year.
And Greg and I would come visit it. But again, like to your point, that's smart that you asked, right? So these are all just intricacies that you need to think about with real estate. So that one makes sense.
Exactly right. Yep.
All right, next
anyway,
one.
I digress.
No, it's a great example. Natural disasters. California wildfires have resulted in home fire insurance rates skyrocketing, as we've talked about. Near forests, this is interesting, that have flammable trees such as the eucalyptus tree. I didn't know we had eucalyptus trees in California. Is that just me being dumb?
We do.
Okay. All right.
I used to have some in our old house.
Okay. Well, apparently they're massively flammable. So that that is a consideration. And then also this expert is saying, I expect the increasingly dire hurricane and storms in Texas, Florida, and Louisiana to hurt neighborhoods that tend to be consistently impacted by them. So natural disasters, right? That has to be a factor that you think about, especially in this day and age, right?
Yep. And I've been hit with that just for the fact that because of all the wildfires in California, they're not writing policies when it comes to most of Steve. In fact, most of Santa Clarita have something to where they're close to some kind of wildfires. And so they canceled me. Geico never had a claim. They canceled me.
I know, which is
we
crazy.
We tried to get a Mercury. Mercury wouldn't sign us. We're paying, I don't know, a lot of money now for fire insurance because you have to have it. But one of the things that they were saying is take pictures. We've got like 12 palm trees around our house. And they're going, palm trees are terrible. It's like, what? Oh, I didn't think that there'd be any big deal. And they're saying, no, the palm fronds, they catch on fire, then they break off, and then they float onto the top of your house. And so we're going, oh, okay, well, that's not good for us. So Jimmy Lewis from Voy Insurance was able to write a policy for us, but everybody's going to have a problem with that now. So that's big time.
Absolutely. Yep. Something to think about for sure. Yep. Okay, so there's a bunch more of these, but we don't have that much longer. So let me go to just the other ones. Quick ones. A trade up for first-time buyers. So as first-time purchasers have hit the market en masse, higher-priced single-family real estate has lagged assets with lower prices. First-time purchasers are now realizing they'd like more space and are wanting to upgrade. Yes? No?
Yes. Everybody seems to be wanting more space for a couple reasons.
And that's
number
the work
one
from
is
home.
Because working from home.
Exactly.
The second one, and this is kind of an interesting thing, is a lot of people during the pandemic actually got animals. These animals grew bigger.
Oh, you're right.
And so they're looking for something to where the animals can now run around in the backyard.
Got it.
And so a lot of times they choose to do that because of growing families, but because also the animals.
Makes sense. Well, hey, you can hear the music in the background. So thank you so much for joining us. But hey, if we want to get a hold of you really quickly, how do we find you?
They can just call the mortuary. they can call me. They can call me at 661. 312-3561 or go to philnordella.com. I promise you I will be well if you decide that you want me to come out. I'll wait until I'm completely better and then go from there. How about you? How do we get a hold of you?
661-259-9000. Thank you for joining us. And Patty, thanks for stepping in as always. Everybody have a great weekend.